along with our good friend Chris Bump from the Fireplace Superstore, because there's a lot of things going on that you need to pay attention to. Obviously, you realize that August is coming to an end, which means a summer is coming to an end as well, and a lot of people and their patio activities are starting to wind down just a little bit.
Well, that also means end of summer deals are happening right now, because it's out with the old, in with the new, and that's so true with Fireplace Superstore right now.
Exactly. We're trying to get the 2018s out to people's homes to get room for the 2019 furniture. We'll start seeing that roll in late November, early December, and then all the way through the winter. So I got to clear the warehouses out, got to clear the showroom out.
All right, now we're talking about a patio furniture that is out right now, and maybe you want to replace it and get a jump on next year too at the same time, but still have plenty of time to enjoy it this year.
Exactly. I mean, the fall is one of the best times to be outside and enjoying your furniture, and I've got a lot of great stuff still. And the thing is, if you can see it on the showroom floor, we'll get you a heck of a deal on it. We can have it delivered out within days. So it's not like something that you're going to be waiting for.
Exactly. It's some cooler nights. Bugs aren't a problem. Get out and enjoy these beautiful Iowa evenings.
You get out and fire up the fire pit, and it's nice in the high 60s or even low 60s. You can sit around there and have an adult beverage or two and relax back in your chairs. And you know, it's the best part about living in the Midwest.
Absolutely.
Right. Now, as we get closer to winter, we'll talk about how you can take care of your patio furniture in general. But you mentioned fire pits, so I want to touch on that too, because this is, especially a morning like today, when we woke up, and later on tonight it's going to be real similar again. This is the perfect type of weather for a fire pit.
Oh, amen for that. Yeah, there it is. Definitely spring and fall are fire pit season. In the summer, even you can use them in the evenings and the night, but it's still a little warm. But now, boy, you really want that extra warmth of the fire.
And how much of a radius of heat does a fire pit put out? How close do you need to be to a fire pit?
Well, it depends on the wind a lot. But 3 to 5 feet on a calm day, on a breezy evening, whoever's downwind,
it's gonna be nice and warm.
8 to 10 foot away, and if you're upwind, we'll put the people who are always warm upwind.
Well, let's talk about what you do have in stock. I think we have some images we can show you. Speaking of fireplaces, you have a couple different options that are available to
people
as well, indoor and outdoor.
We've got a lot of great stuff, and so they just popped up a picture of one of our indoor fireplaces, and that's something else that folks have got to want to get an early jump on this year, because I tell you, it's been a busy early fall, or late summer, early fall already.
How so?
I don't understand it, but I guess once I understand retail, I'll get out of retail and start consulting. but folks have been coming in with projects already, and we're actually quite a bit behind on installs even already.
Now, are these full-blown fireplaces, or are these the inserts, or which ones are you talking about?
A little bit of everything. We're doing quite a few of the retrofits where we're going back into old wood burners, and then we're doing quite a bit of the removal and replacement, pulling the old wood-burning fireplace or old gas fireplace and putting the new unit back in, and then still got a fair amount of construction project work.
Now, you just mentioned you took a gas fireplace out and put a new one in. What would be the reason for doing something like that? If you already have a gas fireplace, why would you want to replace it?
Advances in technology. A lot of the ones that we're replacing are 20, 25 years old, and they were good for 20 or 25 years ago. You don't drive the same car you did 25 years ago as an everyday thing. And if you use your fireplace a lot, you want the newest and best in terms of how the flame looks, in terms of efficiency, electronic ignition. That and sometimes those older ones will start to get a little problematic to maintain. So rather than keeping to throw money at the old one and keeping it running, folks will come in and maybe they want to change the tile or the marble on the front anyway. So you pull that material off, and at that point, heck, it's just a matter of pulling the old unit out, disconnecting the gas and electric, reconfiguring the vent. My guys are in and out of there in 6-8 hours, and you've got a new fireplace where the old one was that you can put your new tile or marble around the outside of.
I was going to say, and you guys handle all of that, correct?
We do all the mechanical portions of
it.
So in terms of we'll remove your old fascia material, remove your old fireplace, do the gas work, the electric work, all the mechanical parts of putting the new fireplace back in, and then we'd have you get with somebody like a Centurion stone or a dowel tile to come in and put your new pretty fascia on the front of it.
On the front of it.
I want to talk about the efficiency and how it's increased over with fireplaces in the past decade or so. Let's go there because they really have jumped leaps and bounds, haven't they?
They were good and now they're great. And we're almost to the point, kind of like with the gas furnace industry, where you just can't get a heck of a lot better. They've done such a great job of making sure that everything heat transfer wise gets into the house as quickly as possible. And the difference in the way the flames look. It's so much prettier the way they've integrated the logs in with the burner.
Right.
You know, on the old ones that we sold back in the late 90s, you had a log and you had a log and then you had a fire and a fire and a fire. And I'm sure that some of your
people hold it up, pick lighters. I'm familiar with,
exactly. And I'm sure some of your viewers are back at home and they're like, yeah, that's what mine looks like. And that was great back then, right? I mean, it was so much nicer than having to go build a wood fire. But now you...
mine was a light bulb with a fan and a piece of flat.
A little tin foil behind it. Yeah, and that was pretty common back then too. But the new ones look so great. You know, they have the logs and the burners are all integrated together as a team. That and you take the electronic ignition that they didn't have back then. You know, we were using essentially water heater technology for years where there was a pilot and a thermocoupler.
Right.
And that pilot was burning all the time, whether or not you were running the fireplace. Well, now the electronic ignition systems are such, you push a button, the pilot comes on, the fire comes on. And the thing that they've done with them also is develop a system where it's a low voltage ignition. So unlike your furnace, we don't need electricity to operate. You can put four AA batteries in your fireplace and the fireplace will run in the event of a power outage.
I was going to say, so in case you lose power, how about that?
Right.
I didn't realize that.
That was always one of the rubs for electronic ignition on fireplaces is, your furnace is pretty useless without power anyway. So no one expects it to work. People really want their fireplace to work even if the power's out. So coming in and having an electronic ignition with low voltage means we can use batteries, like say four AA's in the case of most of mine, and they'll fire right off and run for a couple weeks.
Now, we talked about the heat circumference of a fire pit earlier, but when we were talking about heat being generated from a fireplace.
It's a completely different animal.
It's a different animal because you can heat a room with a fireplace.
You can heat a room. You can heat the majority of a home with them if you really want to. And one of the things that's great with the new ones that didn't exist on the old ones is the variable flame systems. So on the old ones, basically you flip the switch and it was on,
right.
And then you ran it until it was just too warm in there, and then you flip the switch and turn it off.
Mm-hmm.
Well, on the new ones, they'll have 5-6 flame levels on them, so we can adjust how much heat you get by how much fire there is.
Are you kidding?
So I can take on the ones at my house, for example, I like to have mine going for a long time. It tranquilizes my beagles. so they lay in front of the fireplace. And so we like to have it going for an hour and a half, 2 hours minimum in the evenings. So I'll run mine on level one or level two a lot, just because I can run it for 2 hours and not have the room be overly heated. Where with the old style ones, I wouldn't have that option. I'd turn it on, and then 30 minutes later, I'd turn it off. And then
it was full bore.
Right.
Yeah, full bore on or off.
Full throttle or nothing.
Right.
Where you have effectively a variable like a gas pedal now. You can give it as much as you want.
And I know we have another image of a fireplace we can show of another option that we have available. But I can understand if people want to be utilizing these fireplaces very soon as fall is about to approach, they want to know that they have options and get everything set now. So they're ready to go.
And that's a retrofit insert. You'd want to roll your head sideways to look at that one because somebody's got that picture loaded sideways. But what those are designed to do is say you have the old wood fireplace.
Mm-hmm. Like we do,
And you like what's on the front of it. Or you've got brick or stone and it's the whole wall and we're just going to leave that alone. What the retrofit inserts will do is go and fit back inside of that old wood burning fireplace. So I'm able to convert it to a high efficient gas like any of my new gas fireplaces without messing with the fascia that you've got on the front.
Oh,
so
nice.
Nobody would know the difference if they came in.
If you're walking in, it's just going to look like you've got a new fireplace inside of the old brick or stone or tile. So you're able to go in and not do quite as much remodeling in order to get it done.
Okay, let's go another step here. Say you have a current fireplace, a regular wood-burning fireplace, and you do have the front of the fireplace with the doors, and they're not in really good shape. Can you come in and put a gas burner in and put some new doors and things like that on it.
Oh, sure. Yeah. Okay. We can. We have a bunch of different fascia change looks that we can do through Stoll Fireplace, which is my glass door company, where we're able to either get you doors or we're able to get you a whole new fascia with louvers and everything.
Front. Yep.
Okay. So if you want to change the look of the fireplace without changing the look of the finish around it,
okay.
A lot of variable options that way, too. Yeah. We try to be able to kind of be a full service on any of the fireplace equipment that way. You know, with the exception of real brand specific parts, we can deal with most things.
Well, there's a reason you're called Fireplace Superstore is because you can handle those situations. But let's go back to the patio furniture because we want to remind everybody amazing deals going on right now. And let's go to a couple of different brands that you have that are top notch right now, like Meadowcraft and also North Cape. These are brands that are going to be beautiful outside your home.
North Cape's my primary wicker line, and as you see in there is a North Cape Avant group, and that's one that we've featured in a couple of commercials. We buy it heavy because it's popular, and we've got quite a few groups of it left, and that's a Meadowcraft wrought iron deep seating group, and that's one that's also been real popular, so we buy them a little heavy because they're popular, and
right.
I've got quite a few of those left too. And if anybody's looking for some great outdoor stuff, come in, look. I've got a great selection still, and if you see it in my showroom, I will make you a great deal on it, and we'll get it delivered to your home as fast as we can.
I love hearing that. My only thing is, okay, I'm getting this incredible furniture, and I have a couple of months, and then I need to store it, or what do I need to do with it? It's Iowa. Winter's coming eventually.
Sooner or later, yes, as much as we'd like to forget that. on the cushion groups, you're going to want to bring your cushions inside.
Okay.
You can leave the rest of this stuff outside.
The frames are designed to be an all-weather component, so a wrought iron frame or an aluminum with a synthetic wicker. Really, the sun is what does all the damage to those. If you wanted them to last forever, you'd bring them in all summer and put them out all winter. Really, the frames aren't going to get hurt sitting outside. The cushions don't like to freeze. So you're going to want to bring the cushions in if it's going to be below freezing out. But other than that, they kind of thrive on neglect. Just set them out there. And if you want to cover them, cover them. Otherwise, they're fantastic out there on their
own. Where can people find your store at?
We're at 109th and Douglas. Mm-hmm. So if you know where Homemaker Furniture is, Bob Brown Chevrolet. We're kind of halfway between them on Douglas on the south side of the street, exit 126 off I-35.
That awesome. Works.
Thank
Wonderful.
You, Chris. Great to
Great
see you.
Great job as always. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
All right,
appreciate
buddy.
It.
It is 8:52, and we will.